Hey guys, it's Marissa. So today's video is gonna be the truth about social media, and this is gonna kind of be more of like a real talk video, just me talking to you guys about, you know, influencers and social media, Instagram, YouTube, all of that stuff, and just kind of breaking it down, keeping it real, telling some truths, not really spilling the tea, because I feel like this isn't really like a tea spilling video, but more just like a truthful, honest talk with you guys. And make sure and give this video a thumbs up if you love pandas, Chester! And subscribe to join the panda fam! Chester and I are like kind of matching today. It's kind of adorable, if I do say so myself. So nowadays, I feel like everybody has social media, you know, everybody has Instagram and Twitter, and so many people have YouTube channels, and just people are everywhere online. There's a lot of positive things about social media, like you can make new friends, you can kind of connect with people that you didn't even know existed. I feel like making friends in person is a lot harder than making friends online, because I feel like online you can kind of be more yourself and, you know, say things that maybe you'd be too afraid to say in person. And so I feel like in that sense, social media is really good because you can feel like you're connected and like you're like other people, and you can kind of feel like you belong more. There's also some negative things about social media that maybe people don't talk about as much. Instagram especially, because you look at all of these beautiful photos and you just assume that somebody has this perfect life and that they have no problems, because it's like they have body goals and like an 8-pack and, you know, a cute boyfriend and all these designer things and nice clothes and a nice house and a perfect life, and it can make you feel really bad about yourself. You don't know what's real and what isn't. Like, social media, it's just kind of a big blur, and I feel like sometimes you look at photos of somebody traveling the world and they're in a new country every day and they look gorgeous and they have hair goals and makeup goals and everything goals, and you just feel like jealous, or you feel like you're not as good as them. I'll use this example. I knew of this person who's a famous Instagrammer, let's just say that. And this person would travel the world and take like beautiful pictures in crazy locations. And I was talking to someone who had traveled with them, and she said, "Oh man, we didn't get to do anything fun on this trip. It was literally just spending hours doing photo shoots, and like we didn't even get to eat like lunch and dinner sometimes. We would just be eating snacks because we were so busy just taking photos." It kind of made me realize, like, wow, you can look at somebody's photo and have it be the most beautiful thing in the world. You don't know how many hours or hundreds or thousands of photos it took to get that one perfect photo. I feel like so many YouTubers go to Disneyland and they don't go on any rides. Like, all they do is do photo shoots, which is fine, but like, you really go to Disneyland? You don't go on like one ride? Or you go on like one ride and that's it? Not naming names, but like, they only go for photo shoots, and I'm always shocked because I'm like, you literally went on like zero or one rides. This is an offense to Disneyland lovers like Marissa, because every time I go to Disneyland, I literally go on like 20 rides and shows and stuff. And like, I do take photos, but like, I take photos for like 15 minutes, and then like the rest of the 10 hours that I'm there, I'm like going on rides and stuff. So yeah, just, you know, don't feel bad when somebody has perfect photos on social media, because it could have been a photo shoot, you know? They could have spent so many hours taking those photos, and obviously, looking at a photo, you can so easily draw conclusions. You know, once I did a photo shoot, and it wasn't really like even a photo shoot, it was just like I just happened to be out with my camera and took some photos all throughout the day. And when I imported the photos into my computer, there were 1,300 photos. There was over 1,000 photos of me, and guess how many ended up on Instagram so far, at least? One photo out of over 1,000 photos. So, you know, nobody takes a photo of something that they want to forget. Nobody takes a photo like, hey, I'm taking out the garbage, or hey, I'm like, you know, doing homework, so fun. I know so many, you know, people and friends that just feel so sad about social media and just really get depressed about it because they feel like they can't compete with somebody who has these professional photos and who has a photographer and an editor and a hairstylist. And I know that the pressure to be perfect can cause so much stress and so much anxiety and, you know, so many insecurity issues within yourself, and it can really just make you feel down. And I know so many friends who have felt this way. You know, I get tons of messages from you guys every day on like Instagram and stuff saying that that's how you feel. And so I just wanted to let you guys know that there are resources out there. There are people who will listen and people you can talk to about it. And BetterHelp is an amazing resource. They have licensed therapists, and I can't stress how important it is to talk to somebody when you feel insecure or when you feel down or when you feel like social media is just so overwhelming that you just can't. So they have licensed therapists, and you can start talking to somebody within 24 hours, so super quickly if you feel like you just need to talk to someone. And I used to feel really like nervous about in-person therapy. A lot of you guys know that my house burnt down and, you know, my school made me go to therapy after that. And it can just be really intimidating to like go in person, check in, sit in a waiting room and feel like everybody's staring at you or silently judging you. You know, sometimes you just feel more comfortable talking to someone online, and you can chat with them over text, chat, phone, video. So there's so many ways that you can communicate with them. And sometimes I feel like it just helps you to write it out instead of talk about it in person with somebody. Obviously, every single person is different. Maybe some people will like one therapist and not be so crazy about another. Then you can switch your therapist out. I think that this is just a great resource to just feel more comfortable and to just, you know, have an affordable, convenient, and an easy way of talking to someone. And thank you so much to BetterHelp for partnering with me on this video. So I'll have a link down in the description box and also on the screen if you guys want to check out BetterHelp. I definitely recommend it if you feel like you need someone to talk to. Obviously, talking to friends is also a great thing, but sometimes I feel like talking to friends has like been really stressful for me. Like, I remember I had this one friend and she would talk to me for like an hour about her problems, and then I would tell her about one of my problems and she would just be like, okay, so anyway, back to me. Like, she wasn't a good listener. She didn't give advice to me. She was just not someone I could really communicate with or tell my problems to. Like, I felt like it was very one-sided. I feel like a lot of my friends, like, they just want to talk to me about their problems. They don't, like, want to listen to my thoughts or opinions or problems. Like, sometimes people go out of their way to make their life look absolutely perfect and to make their lives look super impressive, and especially like trips and events and parties, the photos and the videos make them look so much funner than they are. Like, you'll see a 10 second Instagram story of a girl at a party, you know, dancing, and I'll be sitting there watching that story being like, I was at that party. It really wasn't that fun. Like, it wasn't as fun as it looks on social media. So you never know what's going on behind closed doors. You don't know like how long somebody spent trying to get that photo or to get that video or to make their life seem perfect. Like, sometimes I'll go to a party and everyone there will just be doing a photo shoot or, you know, on their phones or taking photos, and nobody's enjoying the party, nobody's living in the moment because everybody's just so focused on like, gotta get pics, gotta get pics, gotta get pics, this location, that location. And it can be really exhausting. So don't let somebody's photos, you know, make you feel bad about yourself. Sometimes like Friday, Saturday night, the weekend, you're like on Instagram looking through everyone's stories being like, everyone is having such a great time and I'm a loser and I'm at home and I'm not cool. The best parties and events and days I have are ones where I like forget to take photos because I'm so busy having fun and living. And have fun, live in the moment with your friends, and don't worry about like, oh my god, how is this gonna look on my feed, or like, will this fit with my theme? I think that there's absolutely nothing wrong with wanting to take good photos. Like, obviously, you know, you want to take good photos, but I think like, don't make it the focus of your life and don't let it consume you and don't let it make you feel bad about yourself if you take a photo and you're like, my photo doesn't look nearly as good as this person's or that person's or that person's, and I'm not as cool as them and I'm not as pretty as them. And there's lighting, there's angles, there's clothes that can make you, you know, that can flatter your body more, and so many of these things come into place. You always see those photos on social media of like somebody like standing normal and then somebody like sucking it in and doing, you know, turning their body at like a certain angle and it just looks perfect, and then you got the lighting, that's the same person like within 2 minutes. Like, a big reason why I started this channel was so that girls could be confident, and boys, can't forget about boys, girls and boys, to be confident. So, you know, I just want all of you guys to be happy and to be yourselves. Don't be mean to people. Don't be catty to people. Don't take social media too seriously, I guess, would be the big message that I want you guys to take away from this. You know, don't feel like you have to be perfect 100% of the time. So what's really important is just being yourself, being who you are, and not constantly comparing yourself to other people. And I know this is so much easier said than done, because like, obviously, it's only natural to be like, why aren't I that person? Why aren't I that person? But just try to not compare yourself. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that it helped you guys out. I know that I get so many messages from girls that don't feel confident or feel really insecure. So hopefully, if you're one of those people, just take my advice. Remember everything that I said, that life's not perfect. People on Instagram who take perfect photos are not perfect at all. So thank you guys so much for watching, and remember, I will link BetterHelp below for you guys in case you wanted to check it out or needed somebody to talk to. And I love you guys. Mwah! Big kiss and bye guys!